Story time about how my best friend's dad tried to assault me. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. I repeat, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. I'm now 24, but 10 years ago, a new girl moved into our town. Her and I quickly became best friends in school. She would always come over to my house and have dinner with me and my parents. My parents really grew to love her because she was so polite and really cared about me. The only thing was that she never wanted me to go over to her house. At first, I thought it might be because she was embarrassed of her house or something. And eventually I asked her and she told me that her dad was abusive towards her mom and that that was the reason why she didn't want me to come over. I felt terrible that she had to live like that, so I expressed to my mom that I was really concerned about her. So my mom actually asked my best friend if she wanted to come live with us for a little bit. Let's call my best friend Sarah. Sarah said no because she wanted to be with her mom. But my mom really wanted to help Sarah and her mom. My mom was in an abusive relationship herself when she was younger, so she understood what Sarah and her mom were going through. My mom decided to invite Sarah's mom over for dinner. That's when my mom asked her about their living situation, and Sarah's mom confessed that it was pretty bad. My mom suggested that she should try to get a divorce, and a few weeks later, she filed for divorce. We were all so happy because this meant things would get better for Sarah and her mom. And things did get better. Her dad moved out to his own apartment, and a few weeks later, he had a new girlfriend. I was able to stay over at Sarah's house, and it was really fun. One of the times that I was with Sarah at her house, her dad showed up. But he started making me feel really uncomfortable. He told Sarah that I was the prettiest friend she'd ever had. I could see him staring at me. After he left, Sarah apologized. I went home and tried not to think about it. A few days later, I was walking home when Sarah's dad pulled up next to me. Part 2 is up. Part 2 of how my best friend's dad tried to assault me. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. I repeat, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. One day that I was at Sarah's house, I decided to walk home instead of calling my mom to pick me up. As I was walking home, Sarah's dad pulls up next to me. At this point, I still hadn't forgotten what he had said about me, and I still felt really uncomfortable. He asked me if I needed a ride, and I politely said no. Then he started to laugh and asked me if I was scared of him. Of course I said no, but the truth is that I was. And he said, well then get in the car if you're not scared of me. And I did. As we got closer to my house, he put his hand on my lap. He asked me if I had a boyfriend, and I pushed his hand away. Then he asked me why I was being so rude. I told him that he made me feel uncomfortable, that I just wanted to get out of the car and walk the rest of the way home. He said no because it would be dangerous for me to be by myself walking at night. He put his hand back on my lap and told me that I was really sturdy. That's when he grabbed my hand and tried to put it on his lap. Of course, I pulled my hand away really quick. Then he pulled over really fast and tried to kiss me. I was so beyond disgusted. I just started yelling. And this really took him by surprise because he must have thought that I was just gonna let him. While I was yelling at the top of my lungs, I managed to unlock the car and open the door. I basically threw myself on the ground and he started yelling at me, telling me to shut up. He tried to pull me back into the car, but at this point I was laying on the ground, so he had to pick up dead weight. He grabbed my foot and started pulling me back towards the car, but I started kicking him. He told me that I was overreacting and that he was just trying to be friendly. Luckily, a few of the neighbors heard me screaming because I was right in front of their house. They came outside and ran towards me because they saw me struggling with him. That's when the woman said that she was gonna call the cops. He tried to tell the lady that I was overreacting and that he had only leaned over to put the seatbelt on, but I took it the wrong way. I told her that he tried to kiss me and she started calling the cops. That's when he drove away. I literally could not believe what had just happened. Finally, the cops arrived and so did my mom. I told them everything that happened, and I even told them that he had made a comment about me in Sarah's house a few days before that. They quickly started looking for his car and found him at a parking lot. They arrested him and he spent 2 nights in jail. His girlfriend then went to bail him out. She told the cops that he was with her and that I was just lying and that I made everything up. She even went as far as to tell the police that I had been hitting on him and that she had been a witness to it. She would even call my house at 2 in the morning and hang up. I even saw her car near my house and by my school, which means she was following me. Part 3 is up. Part 3 of how my best friend's dad tried to assault me. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. I repeat, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. I called the police to tell him that his girlfriend was following me. That's when the cop said that I could probably get a restraining order against him and his girlfriend. Sarah and her mom came over to our house after they heard what happened. Of course, they felt really bad, but they weren't surprised. Sarah told me that that's why she never wanted me to come over because her dad had commented things about her friends before. Worst of all is that they couldn't keep him in jail for what he did to me, but a few months later he was finally put into prison because of something else he did. Apparently he had tried to steal a car or something. Remember the crazy girlfriend I told you Sarah's dad had? She kept following me for a long time. She would even show up to my school asking me if I wanted a ride home. Eventually I was able to get a restraining order against her, but she was really scary. A few years ago she tried to follow me on Instagram. I had to block and report her. I mean, what kind of woman would fight for a man like that? The good news is Sarah and I are still good friends to this day. We even went to college together and now have steady boyfriends. Even Sarah's mom remarried and she's really happy with her husband. I look back at what happened as a learning experience, but to be honest, if he ever gets out of prison, I'm scared. Shout out to my follower, Remy, for always supporting me and watching my lives. If you want a shout out, watch my lives to get picked. Bye.
Story time about how I was harassed at the gas station.
A few years ago when I lived in LA, I would walk everywhere. By the way, you guys want more of my own story time, so here we go. The year was 2016. The victim was me. No, but seriously. I didn't have a car at the time. Actually, I still don't have a car because I can't afford one. So I would take the train or the bus everywhere. On this day, I had an audition in Santa Monica, so I decided to take the bus and then the train. When I got off the train, I walked my cute little tush over to the gas station to grab a bottle of water. I went inside, grabbed my water, and I noticed this guy staring at me. You girls know when a guy is staring at you and he's doing it on purpose. Yeah, that's what he was doing. He wanted me to see him staring at me. I quickly exited and started heading toward my audition, which was like 5 blocks away. I was about 20 feet from the gas station when I hear him yelling at me. He started saying like, hey, do you need a ride? Do you need a ride? And I just said, no, thank you. And I kept walking. Cars were on the street, so I couldn't cross the street just then. So he decided to get in his car and pull up right next to me. As he did this, I could hear him complimenting my body. He started talking about my bum and other parts of my body. I put on my headphones and I just ignored him. But obviously this made him even more upset, right? Because, you know, although I did not put music on because I wanted to hear exactly what was going on. That's when he started saying that I was a bitch and other things for not talking to him. Oh yeah, and then I needed someone to teach me a lesson. Finally, I was able to cross the street and I kept walking. This man turned onto the wrong side of the road so that he could drive right next to me and continue to harass me. He started telling me what he was gonna do to me if I actually ever got into his car. I knew that if I responded, it would only accelerate his anger, so I literally did not say anything and kept ignoring him. Finally, some cars were going his way, so he had to get out of the lane and turn around. But this man literally made a U-turn on the street to come back to continue harassing me. I was literally on the verge of tears, but I was like, I'm not gonna let this guy see me cry. Saw a cafe, two doors down, and I decided to walk in. And you better believe he stopped in front of the cafe and just stared inside, waiting for me to come out. Mind you, I had 20 minutes to get to this audition and there was no way I was going to be on time because being on time means being late. But I also did not want him to see where I was going. I went up to the girl at the register and explained to her what was happening. And I just started to cry. Luckily, she was super nice. She gave me a glass of water and just told me to sit down. Luckily, this guy didn't have any patience, so he did drive away. And then I was finally able to walk to the audition, which was like another 3 blocks away. This is why I always used to wear oversized shirts over any dress that I had. Like I have this really big button-up shirt that just hides my body perfectly, but still this happened. No, I didn't have time to get his license plate. I still remember what he looks like and what kind of car he was driving, but honestly, what am I gonna do? Call the cops and be like, hey, this guy harass me. I sometimes literally stand in front of my closet and think, no, I'm not gonna wear that unless I'm with my husband. If you have any similar stories, please comment below because I know I'm not the only one. Also, no matter what you're wearing, you should never be approached like that. If you ever find yourself in a situation like that, just go into a store and wait it out. Who cares? It's better than having them follow you to where you live, you know? Just be safe out there. I love you guys. Bye.